Mr. President, I'm Jackie Belanti, the DSA Manager.
Pleasure.
Pleasure.
Pleasure for all of us here, and I want you to know you're pretty brave to come here, because they tell me that this is the worst place for us people, because I take allergy shots, but they tell me this is the worst place for us, Washington. There's more kinds of trees and all. And last week was something of a record. The pollen count was 138.
It's all over my car.
And I can testify to thank all of you for what you're doing to us.
We appreciate you.
Please appoint asthma and allergy foundation to my committee.
Well, thank you very much.
And these are for my school.
Well, thank you very much. Well, I'm pleased to have those, and I see there's a corsage there for Mrs. Reagan. I'll see that she gets those. And inside there, yet end a button there for me. Thank you.
I love my allergies.
I love my allergies. I'll have to wear that when I go for my next show. I will. Well, not totally empty-handed here. Now, these are just samples, so that you won't have to open the box right now. But in the box is a jar with the presidential crest on it, the seal on it, and it's filled with jelly beans.
I may never open that.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And I thought it would save opening to see what it was if I gave you some samples in advance. Bless you.
Thank you.
Well, that's, oh Lord, I forgot to mention that. I know she's straight A.
That's right, that's right. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. President?
Hi.
I think you know these fellows.
Yes,
brothers.
How are you?
Yes.
Good to see you, brother.
What is the fellow with
you? Oh, yeah.
We're
going to
vice
your
president.
Hi.
How are
you?
New son, how are you?
I'm Deborah Dean, Secretary of Pierce Executive Assistant. Nice to meet you.
I'm Cody Monroe.
Oh, thank you. Secretary for
John Adams.
Thank you. Well, I think you two and the mayor are supposed to
work. That's right.
Sign
a
proclamation.
Yep.
A little late in April.
Well, we're going to get there before the end.
I didn't order that.
We'll have you on the right, Sam.
Oh, okay.
We'll have
the left.
Well, Sam, I want to thank you especially for your work in the partnership and fair housing here and what it means. And Ed, you for making sure that we carry on this fair housing. I think it's very important, and our administration is going to be totally behind it. I know it sounds a little funny here to put that date on.
No, it's
well, no matter what the date, we've been working all month.
That's
on,
right.
So,
that's right, Ken.
All right. It's done.
Well, thank you.
Good night.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. Sam, you have a banner.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. We have a banner here, and we'd like to have a picture taken. And what if we could bring in the members of my staff?
Sure.
Sure.
That, so they could come in and have this. Ed, come on over here. I want you to get a picture, too. You'd get here and have a picture here with Fair Housing Month.
It's upside down.
Oh my God. I'm scared to jump out of it. Okay, thank you. Mr. President, thank you ever so much. I want you to have those.
Oh, well, thank you. All right.
All right, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Mr. President.
Thank you all.
Thank you very much.
President, this is Mr. Ramos from Madrid.
Nice to press you.
Barcelona.
Pleasure to meet you personally.
Well, my pleasure.
And I just want to tell you that I am one of your many fans, and that there is many people in Spain who appreciate your efforts for economic strength in the world and for peace, freedom, and democracy.
I think they wanted a picture in which we're sitting as if, as if we're interviewing a well, we're looking forward to our trip there.
Have you ever been in Spain?
Oh, yes. As a matter of fact, when I was a governor of California, President Nixon asked me to do a mission for him that took me to Spain as well as some other European countries. And we, from Madrid, we went to Toledo. We were there and in the Alcazar. Yes, heard the whole story of that. So for the,
thank you, Mr. President.
Very enjoyable.
I really wish you a happy and pleasant trip to all of you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
From El Pais.
Nice to see you.
Yes, I will. Thank you. It's great to again after you were there.
Like Bob, take the chair over there. Well, we're looking forward to our visit. Great pleasure. It will be our second trip. We've been there once before. It was Rega and I.
You have a good remember from your first trip?
Very good. I was just saying to your compatriot here, who was in here, one of our trips from Madrid was to Toledo, to the Alcazar, and heard the whole story and visited that. Most enjoyable.
You will be much better now with the schedule. You better worse now to go to Toledo. You couldn't do it now.
You couldn't?
No, I mean, you are very impressed with your schedule. But
oh.
It's a pity. You will go to the good fight or so now?
No.
First lady will go?
No, but we went to a cafe where some young lady that was supposed to be quite prominent dancing, as a dancer, was there. And in one part of her act, she got me up on the floor with her.
Thank you,
Mr. Nice to be here. I hope you enjoy it.
Well, I'm sure we will. Hey, now there.
How are you?
How are you? Come on, take the chair right over there.
Yes, no, you look very, very young, I think. Yeah. You look very young, no?
Yeah.
Younger.
Yeah.
Younger.
Oh, thank you. That was a word I hadn't expected to hear. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Great pleasure.
Gentlemen, I got to change of film here.
Yes.
All right.
Did you hear that?
I'm sorry. There'd be two president and two, one in the chair.
You're right.
Yeah.
Well,
president. In the room. Mr.
Senior.
SCMR.
I think they want us for a picture sitting down.
Good.
Would you like to take the chair and you be right there in the corner of the
diagram? Thank you.
Well, it's a great pleasure. We're looking forward to our visit.
Did you take a lot of chance in Spain since last time you were there in 1972?
This will be the first trip since that. Yeah. We had a very nice time then. The Patriots who were in here, we visited Toledo and the Alcazar when we were there before.
Would like another change now.
Changes?
Yeah, I hope so.
I hope for the better, huh?
Yeah, of course.
All right.
Was the first lady on that trip with you also at that time, Mr. President?
Was that?
Was the first lady with you on that trip also?
Yes, and our son, who was only about 10 years old at the time, was with us, and he has a very treasured souvenir. They gave him one of the books off the shelf in the office, the colonel's office of the Alcazar, with where the bullet had gone through the back of the book in the battle.
He
treasures that very much.
He still has it then.
Oh, yes.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Well, all right. Well, good to see you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
President. Next, we have a lady that's been working for NSC for 40-some-odd years. We're not sure exactly how many years. Kathy just said, I just checked again, she said over 40 years. Mm. So her name is Sammy Newman, a lady named Sammy Newman. She's going to bring her family, and I guess there's a total of 6 or 7. Now, Bud has already given her a presidential gift, glasses or something, but we thought it'd be nice if you gave her the rest of her family gifts. That's something else Bud's going to take care of later on, but that's for Sammy. This is the family photo, and she's leaving after all these years.
All right.
So she's obviously career, not political. Sam Newman.
Hi, Mr. President.
Hi.
How are you today? Good to see you.
See you.
I'd like to introduce Sammy Newman, who's retired after 44 years of government service, 30 of which are here at the White House.
Oh, listen, you know something? The way these last few days have been, wait till I get my hat, I'll go with you.
Well, I thought you might want to see, of course, the bracelet with your seal, sir. Then I have the 40-year term on here with the ruby.
Oh.
So,
how would you like to add one more charm?
Oh, sir, thank you. Did you know I served on the Rockefeller Commission with you?
Of
1975?
Yes. Yes.
And I put a shamrock in your briefing folder on St. Patrick's Day.
Yes.
So the meeting would have good luck. And you know, I think that shamrock has taken over the rest of your career, because that's where you are.
Well, bless you.
The other members of the
May I introduce my sister, Mrs. Emma Henry?
Nice to see you.
Quitwheel, Tennessee. Former career girl, she paved the way. We're both United Nations Conference girls, so I have a lot to thank her for.
I'll come back the next summer.
And her daughter, Mrs. Sandra Pello from DeSoto, Texas.
Well,
from Dallas. I'm very glad to meet you.
Well, glad to meet you.
Thank you for sharing time with us.
And her other daughter, Mrs. Rita Huddleston from Quitwheel, Tennessee.
Well, nice to see you.
Thank you.
And my other sister, Mrs. O'Jill Blythe from Quitwheel, Tennessee.
I bring you a lot of well wishes for you, Tennesseans.
Well, thank you very much.
And her daughter, Mrs. Linda Kinkle from Cape Coral, Florida. And her son, Jim Brown from Cape Coral, Florida. And sir, one of your greatest advocates in Okinawa, United States Staff Sergeant Dwayne Blythe. He has your pictures all over the barracks over there.
Well, now, I think we ought to have a
her
family.
Her youngest son.
Hey, wait a second. I saved the best for last. Nice
to meet you. Nice to meet you. I think we ought to gather around and have a family picture.
Oh, right? Where would you like?
Everyone looking right here. Sir. Thank you, sir.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. President. God bless you. We all love you.
Thank you for all those years of service to the country. Thank you very
much.
Thank you.
All right. Sergeant.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
My pleasure.
A knife for his 13th birthday. Cufflinks for Dennis, who is leaving Max's staff, and a stick pin for his wife.
All right. And I hope they don't mind their 13-year-old having a pocket knife.
I mentioned that to Kathy, and she said, oh, he can take it to school with him. I said, a knife to school? And she said, sure, he can show it to everybody. And I said, well, okay.
At least it's not a presidential switchblade.
President?
Hi.
How are you, sir?
How are you?
Hi, sir. Well, my son, David.
Hello, David.
It's my wife, Dawn.
It's a pleasure to see you.
Well, nice to see you.
You're kind to have us come in.
Well, listen, very pleased to. I don't know whether I have your parents' permission to do this or not, but I thought maybe it being your birthday, the little pocket knife here, you'd be all right.
Thank you.
Well, you're more than welcome.
I had a hard time getting out of school today, convincing my students and teachers that I'm coming here. Said I needed a note from them to have an excuse.
Well, when you show her that knife, she'll know that you've been here because my name's on it.
That's great. That's very good.
All right.
Well, thank you. Enjoyed working with you.
Tell her thanks for letting you out. I'm pleased to see you and be able to say happy birthday.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. President. Well, enjoyed working with you, sir.
Well, thank you for everything.
You're very kind. I enjoyed it. Enjoyed working with Don Regan at Treasury. Enjoyed working for you. And I hope I can do it, continue doing it on the outside. Try to help the economic recovery a little bit.
All right.
Thank you again.
Thank you, sir.